We want to evaluate arc cotangent of negative 3.5 both in degrees and radians. Arc cotangent negative 3.5 is equal to some angle theta that has a cotangent function value of negative 3.5. So again, cotangent theta must equal negative 3.5, but there's an infinite number of angles that have a cotangent function value of negative 3.5. So we need to be aware of the output or range for the arc cotangent function. It's sketched here below in red. Notice the range or output would be on the open interval from 0 to pi radians. So angle theta must be on the open interval from 0 to pi radians. Well, if we're talking about degrees, theta must be on the open interval from 0 degrees to 180 degrees. So if we go to the coordinate plane just for a moment, our angle theta must have an initial side here along the positive x-axis, and then must terminate in either the first or second quadrants. But we also know that the cotangent function value is negative, so that means our angle must terminate in the second quadrant. Since this trig function value is not going to give us one of the common reference angles, we will have to use the calculator, but there's not an arc cotangent button on the calculator. So now we need to make the connection that if cotangent theta is equal to negative 3.5 or negative 3.5 over 1, since tangent and cotangent are reciprocals, tangent theta must equal the reciprocal of this function value, or negative 1 over 3.5. And if this is true, then we could say that arctangent of negative 1 divided by 3.5 must equal theta. And this is helpful because there is an arctangent button on the calculator. So now we'll go to the calculator. Let's do this in degrees first. So we'll press the mode key. Notice how degree is highlighted. So we'll go back to the home screen. And now we're going to press second tangent for arctangent or inverse tangent. And now we'll type in negative 1 divided by 3.5. And notice how the calculator gives us approximately negative 15.95 degrees. But this can't be our angle because this is in the wrong quadrant. But let's go ahead and write this down. The calculator gave us theta is approximately negative 15.95 degrees, which would be this angle here. Which is not our angle, but it does tell us the reference angle that we need in the second quadrant. Again, because our cotangent function value is negative and our angle must terminate in quadrant 1 or 2, we can sketch a 15.95 degree reference angle in the second quadrant, again because our cotangent function value is negative. So this is the angle that we need. And there's a couple ways of determining this angle. What we could do is just use the angle that the calculator gave us and then add 180 degrees. So our angle theta, which has to be in these intervals, would be approximately equal to negative 15.95 degrees plus 180 degrees, which is equal to 164.05 degrees. And then for the angle in radians, we could convert this to radians, or we can go back to the calculator, change the mode to radians. So press mode, highlight radian, press enter, go back to the home screen, and press second tangent, again, negative 1 divided by 3.5. This is going to give us the angle in radians in the fourth quadrant, and then from here, we'll add pi radians. So plus second exponent key here, the caret, enter. And see the angle that we want is going to be approximately 2.86 radians. So again, the calculator gave us approximately negative 0.28 radians. And then we added pi to this to come up with the angle that we wanted, which was approximately 2.86 radians. Okay, I hope this explanation was helpful.